There are many benefits to growing vegetables in a polytunnel, especially here in the Irish climate, where it can be used to create much better growing conditions for most of the year, especially for the warm season crops. But there are costs associated with this type of structure. They can be relatively expensive to purchase and put up, but the increase in yield and quality of what you can grow in this shelter that they create means that a polytunnel can essentially pay for itself in one growing season. There are other non-financial costs, many of which I would broadly term ecological costs, with pollution, resource extraction, energy use, and the eventual disposal of them being potentially problematic issues. And I think that we should recognize and account for, or at least acknowledge, these externalized costs where possible. These days, there's a lot of focus on the problems with plastics, and there's plenty of good reasons to question their use. And I've been wondering if I should really be relying on the use of plastics in my growing spaces, or is it something that I should avoid as much as possible because the material is so ecologically problematic? Or can the considered use of this valuable material in the gardens have such significant benefits that it can outweigh the costs or problems, and perhaps even significantly reduce the use of plastics and other resources elsewhere in our societies? Of course, I'm not the first person to be concerned with this, and decades ago, Elliot Coleman explored this issue in one of his books. He did an excellent analysis of the energy required to produce a plastic for use on a polytunnel to grow just one crop of lettuce on his farm in Maine in the United States. He then calculated that it actually took more energy to transport the same amount of lettuce from California. And because the plastic would last many seasons, he could easily produce at least 6 crops of lettuce for less total energy than it would take to transport just one crop across the country. He concluded that although fossil fuels were used in the creation of the plastic, it was substantially less than the energy needed to transport the food in from far away, and therefore justified its use in our gardens and farms. I've always liked this type of analysis, and I've been meaning to do similar calculations for my context, only using greenhouse gas emissions as the main unit for comparison. 2 years ago, I purchased and put up a fairly large polytunnel, and the single sheet of polythene or polyethylene plastic that covered the steel frame weighed 70 kilograms. According to research I've done, there is about 6 kilograms of carbon dioxide released for every kilogram of plastic through its whole life cycle, including the incineration of the plastic at the end of its life. Making plastic requires the energy from fossil fuels, as well as the carbon contained in even more fossil fuels as the feedstock or main ingredient of the plastic itself. I've calculated that incinerating 1 kilogram of plastic will release about 3 kilograms of carbon dioxide, but until then this fossil carbon is sequestered or held in the plastic itself. This leaves about 3 kilograms of carbon dioxide released in the process of manufacturing 1 kilogram of plastic. So that means that 210 kilograms of carbon dioxide emissions were released into the atmosphere to manufacture this big sheet of plastic for my new polytunnel. This particular plastic was manufactured in Italy, about 3,000 kilometers away, and there will have been even more emissions getting it to me in Ireland. Using estimations of emissions for road transport in Europe, this would add another 30 kilograms of carbon dioxide emissions to get the plastic to me. This brings the total to about 240 kilograms of carbon dioxide emissions to make and deliver the plastic, and another possible 210 kilograms when the plastic ceases to be useful, hopefully in many years. But it's not just about the plastic, of course, as there is also the steel frame. This skeletal structure is made from a total of about 425 kilograms of steel pipe, and there is apparently 1.83 kilograms of carbon dioxide emissions released for the manufacture of each kilogram of steel. This would mean that 780 kilograms of carbon dioxide was released for manufacturing the frame of this polytunnel. The steel pipe was produced in the UK, probably about 600 kilometers away, and there would have been approximately an additional 40 kilograms of CO2 released in the transportation. That brings the total to 820 kilograms of carbon dioxide emissions to produce the steel frame and to get it to me in the middle of Ireland. That is more than 3 times the emissions that there was from the plastic, which is really interesting as so much emphasis is placed on the plastic as being the problem. In total, I've estimated that there was just over 1 ton of carbon dioxide emissions to manufacture the polytunnel frame and plastic and to transport it all to me. I've no doubt that the actual emissions were higher than this, as this type of calculation doesn't include everything, but I think that 1 ton would account for the bulk of the emissions involved. This is a significant amount and would have contributed to the increase in greenhouse gases in the atmosphere, adding to the problems of climate change for many years to come. To put this one ton into context, a return transatlantic flight from Dublin, Ireland to my home in Toronto, Canada would produce the equivalent of 1.5 tons of carbon dioxide emissions per passenger. Or looking at this another way, the same amount of emissions would be caused by transporting about 2.5 tons of vegetables from Spain to Ireland, where we currently get a lot of our vegetables from, especially the warm season crops. In a polytunnel of this size, I can easily grow 1 ton of vegetables a year, which can be seen as replacing a similar amount of food that would otherwise have to be imported from Spain or even farther away. So the emissions caused in manufacturing this polytunnel would easily be paid back within 3 years, and there would be a net benefit from a carbon emissions standpoint after that, for as long as I'm growing in this polytunnel. This, of course, doesn't take into consideration the substantial emissions in transport infrastructure of roads and the truck itself, and it ignores the likelihood that significant amounts of plastic would have been used in the growing of the food in Spain, and it also ignores the inevitable plastic packaging that would have been involved. If I was able to do a whole life cycle analysis of all of these factors, I suspect that I would end up finding that there would be a net climate benefit to growing vegetables in a polytunnel here in Ireland after just one season. The longer I grow food in this polytunnel and the more productive it is, the greater the benefit. Or another way of looking at it is that the ecological cost can be seen as spreading out over many years. I expect the steel frame to last at least 20 years, but the plastic will probably not last that long. This quality of plastic is supposed to last about 7 years, and I would theoretically need to replace the plastic twice for the polytunnel to last a full 20 years. So that is 3 sheets of plastic in total, plus one that I already needed to replace due to a massive damage by fire. Ignoring the fact that I will be reusing a lot of this plastic for other purposes in the gardens, and assuming that all 4 sheets of plastic are incinerated at the end of their life, the emissions from the 4 sheets of plastic and from the steel frame would total 2.6 tons of carbon dioxide. Averaged over the 20-year period, this would only be about 130 kilograms of carbon dioxide emissions per year. This is about equal to the emissions from transporting less than 300 kilograms of vegetables from Spain each year. Again, not counting all the other emissions related to their production or packaging. Looking at this another way, 130 kilograms of carbon dioxide emissions a year is equivalent to about 1,000 kilometers of travel in a relatively efficient car. So one return trip a week to the local town to buy groceries would produce more emissions than this polytunnel would, if averaged over a full lifespan of 20 years. Of course, it is possible to grow vegetables here in Ireland without the use of any plastics or any kind of protected cropping at all, and perhaps that's something that we should be aiming for. Personally, I think the benefit of growing with the assistance of a polytunnel makes this ecological cost more than worthwhile. I think I would probably eliminate plastics from all other parts of my life and reduce carbon emissions from a lot of other activities before I would give up this type of protected cropping. Fundamentally, I believe that plastic is a very useful and amazing material. We just use way too much of it for things that are so unimportant. But again, it's not just about the plastic. We should be mindful about all the resources that we use to produce our food and to take care of them so that they can last as long as possible and to get as much benefit out of them as we can. And I think it's important to do this type of ecological accounting with all of the methods, tools, and equipment that we use to produce our food without getting too caught up in the details. And at the end of the day, I think it's just so important to simply grow food for ourselves and our communities, and to try to grow as much as we can throughout the year if possible. And if we can do that in ways that reduce the negative externalities, the pollution, waste, and the greenhouse gas emissions, all the better. An important part of this Red Gardens project that I'm working on is to better understand the issues and benefits of growing your own food, regardless of what method you use, compared to importing your food from elsewhere. And I plan to continue to share all of the data and analysis that I develop on this YouTube channel so that it may help to develop and change policy and encourage many more people to grow more of their own food for themselves and their community, for the benefit of everyone and the planet. If you'd like to support me on this project, please check out my Patreon page linked here, or there's other suggestions in the description below. But most importantly, thank you for watching.